As the ball is going to be thrown up, and it's going to be controlled by the Seawolves. Warney at 6'8", Charlie Jones at 6'4". The 4-inch difference there, edge to Stony Brook, and they were able to take advantage of it. The Seawolves perfect at home this season, just 1-4 away. Pass underneath, and Warney able to get the scoring started for Stony Brook.
And if Warney gets the ball that close, Dan, it's going to be a long night for the Eagles. Can't let him get the ball in like that.
Eagles with a pair of freshmen in the starting lineup tonight and have been in the starting lineup for a while. Delonte Jones with the basketball now, passing off to Maragos, looking for a friendly. Now Jesse Reed with the basketball. Passes off to Washington. 4 seconds on the shot clock, and Washington able with the pull-up drain to tie things up.
Just the athleticism off the dribble there for James Washington, able to kind of dribble himself into some space and knock down that open shot.
Now Walker trying to pass down underneath to Warney, and the pass a little too high and ahead. And we talked about it a little bit in the open, but everything that the Seawolves do goes through Warney, who's a legitimate NBA prospect.
Yeah, legitimate NBA prospect. You see the replay there from Washington's shot, but also a guy that might have some long-term overseas career, if not in the NBA.
Maragos, turnaround shot, unable to get it to go. And the rebound comes down for Walker. Seawolves this season averaging 78 points a game.
Played some quality competition as well.
Underneath, it's going to be taken away. McGrew unable to keep a handle on it. Delonte Jones stops, pops, and unable to connect, but there is going to be a whistle.
Delonte, a nice steal there, and again, showing off one of the great skills, parts of his skill set, the fact he can go ahead and dribble the ball like a guard, even though he's kind of close to that forward size, at least in the Patriot League.
Delonte at 6'5", 195 pounds, 67% free throw shooter. His shot is up and no good. 10 of 16 on the season. You were mentioning that the Seawolves have had a pretty good schedule to date. Pushed Vanderbilt to overtime. Lost that game by 7 as the shot's up and good that time from Jones. So the Eagles were able to take the lead 3-2. Also went to Notre Dame. Got blown out in that one by 25. They did beat Loyola of Maryland. The shot is up and no good there. Underneath, a battle for it, and it's going to be a jump ball.
Yeah, and getting back to that point, Dan, that Vanderbilt game, from a lot of people said Stony Brook actually kind of blew that game. They had it well in control and down the stretch kind of made some big mistakes and let it get away. But this Stony Brook team, they've got the eyes on making the NCAA tournament. That's their goal. They're their favorite in their league, and they've come oh so close the last few years looking to get over the hump.
They have yet as a program to make it to the NCAA tournament. Maragos underneath, a little move and a little bucket. His first points of the game, nice move there for Paris, twisting around, not finding his way the one way, and then turning and getting it. Now at the other end, answering is Warning.
And right there, as the coaching staff, you may have caught it, saying, hey, you got to run back and forth. You got to stay in front of him. If you let him pin you off the backside, that's going to be a bucket every time.
Ball knocked away and out of bounds. Last to touch, though, was Puriefoy, so the basketball stays with the Eagles with 19 seconds on the shot clock.
Here's that nice move there, just being patient by Paris, keeping the pivot foot down and making a nice move to get it in.
Now from the corner, the shot is up and no good from Washington. Delonte trying for the rebound, unable to handle it. It's out of bounds, and the Seawolves will get possession.
Good job by Delonte to get up there. Just couldn't grab it again. That strength that's going to come as deeper as he gets in this American program.
Left corner, Puriefoy now passing out. McGrew drives. His shot is short underneath. The putback is good.
It's a long day if the Eagles can't keep Stony Brook off the board. You're going to expect Warney to get a few of those, but those guards, you got to make sure you're boxing out.
The Eagles have had trouble in the rebounding department this season. Not so much for Stony Brook. They average 11 more rebounds a game than their opponent. Jesse Reed dials one from long distance and connects.
That's a big one, Dan. The coaching staff for American said,
And now they answer with a three at the other end, and that puts Stony Brook on top.
Just that quick, but American's coaching staff told us, hey, look, you know, one of the things they do, they kind of go under screen sometimes. We're going to get open looks. We've got to hit them. Jesse Reed did.
Maragos being accosted, passes out. Delonte open, puts up the three and drains it. Back on top go the Eagles by two.
A little bit unbalanced on defense for Stony Brook. Three guys converged on Paris looking for the steal. Left Delonte wide open out at the arc.
Walker passing underneath. Now they're working it back out. The shot is up and just off the rim. In the battle for the basketball, it ends up out. Last to touch was Walker, so the basketball goes to the Eagles, but we'll take a timeout because they're doing it on the floor. It's 11-9 AU leading Stony Brook on Patriot League Network.
Treat yourself to an ice cold Coke, Diet Coke, or Sprite. At the concession stand now. You can also purchase hot dogs, pizza, pretzels, popcorn, nachos, as well as chips, candy, and more. For your convenience, the stand proudly accepts Eagle Box dining.
And we'll be back right after this.
And now, please turn your attention to the bingo board and sing along with the words to the AU fight song.
Inside Bender Arena, back and forth affair here early on between the Eagles and Seawolves. Right now, AU is up two. And Jeremy, the Eagles have done a good job of spreading the wealth around. 4 points here early on for Delonte James with a couple, three for Jesse, and a couple for Paris.
You just saw on that replay there that the player for Stony Brook went underneath the screen. They'll do that sometimes in their defense. Again, shots have been there for the Eagles. The good thing today is they've knocked them down.
Handoff goes to Delonte, out along the three-point line. Now he passes out to Charlie. Paris driving the paint. Turnaround shot is up, and it's no good. Crashing the boards, the Seawolves. Puriefoy working out to Walker, and he's going to have the double dribble. So the Eagles will get the basketball back and a chance to add to their two-point lead.
And Walker, a guy who had been on this team before, was gone from the team last year, went and spent a year at a junior college, has come back, kind of adding another dimension to this team. Again, as we talked about, Dan, this is a squad that's got the eyes on the prize of the NCAA tournament. They've lost, I believe, two of the last 3 years in the conference final. That's what they're shooting for. You see teams like that always got the extra edge.
Charlie underneath with the reverse, and the Eagles are now up four.
Some of the film I saw on this Stony Brook team, because of the way they play, if you make some good cuts, they can be susceptible to that. Charlie Jones got a good basket off a nice cut and a nice dish.
And the Eagles have shown some signs this year of having those crisp cuts and really getting them to go. Of course, it depends on who they're going up against and the style that they're going up against, but right there, showing that they can do it. Puriefoy is going to draw a whistle as Charlie Jones gets a little bit aggressive.
Here it is. You see just a nice move there by Charlie to get under the bucket, the reverse finish to keep the shot blocker from getting to the ball, and Paris with a nice look to get him.
And that's going to be important for Paris, not just to score, but have the eyes to be able to touch it out to the other guys. As we wind down the first part of the season, you know, a lot of coaches say there are three seasons in college basketball, non-conference, end conference, and then postseason. from the left corner. Three-point attempt is up, and it's good from Lucas Woodhouse, the junior guard transfer from Longwood.
Yeah, Woodhouse has been dealing with that knee. You see his brace there, but when he's healthy, he can be a real good addition to this squad.
Paris passing underneath to Washington, who lays it up and in. Another nice cut for the Eagles, and the freshman now playing with 4 points. The Eagles' lead sits at three.
This is a good lineup for the Eagles. Got that mix of youth and experience, athleticism and smarts, really working well against the Seawolves.
Step up, long shot, no good, and the rebound comes down for Delonte.
Yeah, but you talk about that. You know, Mike Brennan kind of said early on, hey, I'm not worried about it early on. We just need to learn to play, then conference play comes.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, we've seen it so many times. Well, we've seen it the first couple of seasons that Mike has been here where they've struggled non-conference, but then they've been able to battle back and do really well in conference play.
Yeah, you see that cut there by James Washington. I don't know if he does that early in the season just because he doesn't know when to cut. Now he's been around the offense. He's been in it for a month more, actually, if you count the preseason. He's just learning his way.
Turnaround shot is up, and it's good, as Jameel Warney is now playing with 6 points. You mentioned how the Eagles have a nice mix of youth and experience. Well, Stony Brook pretty much brings just experience, as last year they didn't have any seniors on their squad.
Yeah, and again, it's nice to be able to bring pretty much a whole team back. America knew that last year.
Reed passing off, but it'll end up out of bounds. And with that, Stony Brook gets the basketball. Yeah, Stony Brook returning all five of their starters. And as you mentioned, they're looked at as the number one team again in the America East. See if they can get over the hump. They have yet to get to the NCAA tournament as a D1 school. They jumped up to Division I back in 1998.
Yeah, Albany really been in their way in the America East. Good quality program with the Great Danes.
Puriefoy. Quick ball movement. Secunda. Now the shot is up for Nyama, and it's good from long range. So Nyama comes off the bench and chips in with a three-pointer. He shoots 38% from beyond the arc and makes that one count.
They've got some pretty good shooters on this Stony Brook team, which is big when you got that nice guy in the middle to draw some extra attention.
Now Washington looks to answer with a three. However, it's off the rim, and Nyama is able to control the boards for the Seawolves. And the shot is up, and it's good for Puriefoy, who gets on the board for the first time in this game, coming in averaging almost 13 points a game. The Seawolves on a bit of a run have opened up a four-point lead.
Yeah, Mike Brennan didn't like that shot by Washington. Not only a quick one, but it leads to a break the other way for the Seawolves.
Jones finding himself in a little trouble, passing out to Modich, puts it on the deck. And that's going to be a call. It goes against AU and against Modich. And that'll bring us to a media timeout. 11:54 left to play here in the first. The Seawolves on a bit of a run, up four on the Eagles. 19:15 on the Patriot League Network.
Fans and alumni, now through this Sunday, December 20th, prior to tip-off of the Eagles men's
home game versus Maryland Eastern Shore, is your chance to take advantage of AU men's basketball's Bender Weekender five-game ticket mini plan. For just $96 per seat, you'll receive a sideline chairback ticket to five great weekend games. Treat yourself or give to friends, clients, and neighbors this holiday season. Purchase your Bender Weekender mini plan at AUEagles.com/tickets or by calling 202-885-TIXX today.
So high.
Back inside Bender Arena, where right now it's a four-point lead to Stony Brook up on American University, 19-15. And Jeremy, when you look at the stats so far, both teams are actually shooting pretty well. The Eagles from the field, 6 of 10. Stony Brook, 8 of 12, both in the 60s.
Yeah, and the Eagles, you're going to have to do more of that. Really, a lot of these early games, they just haven't shot the ball well. You're hoping that's going to be the case moving along.
Woodhouse feeds off to Puriefoy. He drives. His shot is up, and it's no good. But there is going to be a whistle. That's going to go against Modich, so he picks up a couple of quick ones.
And, of course, the problem with air is that Modich had to cover for James Washington, kind of got out of position, and Puriefoy got by him. But talking after last year's game, Puriefoy, as he makes his shot, gave Pee Wee Gardner a lot of trouble last year, by as much as anybody during the season. So if you've got a guy who's played very well against a Pee Wee Gardner, you can expect what's going to happen when you got a talented but a freshman going up against him this year.
Next shot is up. That one rattles around. It's no good from Puriefoy, who's a 75% free throw shooter. 5-point lead for Stony Brook.
Right now, if you're the Eagles, you got a kind of a smallish lineup on the court here. Got to make sure you're getting movement. Take advantage of what you have. You should have some foot speed matchups.
Marco Vasic has entered the lineup on the floor for the Eagles. Reed fires one from long distance, unable to get it to go. However, Delonte controls the boards. His shot is up, and it's good. Nice stick-to-itiveness there from the Eagles' freshman. A little aggression and a little stick-to-itiveness. He now has 6 points.
And a good job knowing he had a mismatch. Woodhouse was between him and the basket. He's taller, better athlete. Go up there and score it.
Nyama, as he drives, ends up hitting Jesse Reed in the face. Looked like maybe getting him in the nose. Nyama, a very aggressive play there, so he is whistled, and Jesse Reed quick to get up, but he's checking his nose to make sure that he's okay.
Yeah, Jesse caught one. Yeah, we know Jesse's a tough kid from Pennsylvania. He's not going to be faking a play like that. He got caught. Well, the question I kind of have is, if he hadn't gotten caught in the face, is that going to be a charge there? We know that the freedom of movement rules and different rules, a little bit calling things different this year, but he got caught pretty good in the face, and now it looks like the referees are checking the monitor real quick. That's a pretty quick check. They're already coming back to the court.
Now they're talking things over with Coach Brennan, who seems not to be too pleased with what they decided.
Get the foul and they get the turnovers, that's important. On the other side, Steve Pico, of course, giving the other referee a little bit of an earful. So, of course, you never can please the coaches, and usually you can't please either one of them. They're always going to find something.
Yeah. You mentioned Pico, graduate of UConn back in 1990, his 11th season at Stony Brook, and he's really grown it into a very good program. Delonte able to save that one off his shoestrings. Charlie with the high dribble now finds Delonte. Charlie will take it back. 10 seconds to shoot. Quick bounce pass underneath. Now a fire from the right corner. Rattles around in and out. Washington had a good thought there. Unable, though, to get it to go.
A good job by Jesse Reed. Couldn't get the layup because the pass was a little bit off. Thought quickly and got the pass out to Washington for a good look.
Sturdivant feeds off to Walker. Now Nyama. Four seconds on the shot clock. Woodhouse passes out. Top of the key. The shot is up, and it's good. Nyama able to hit it from long range. That's his second made three. That's what he does well. 38% shooter from beyond the arc.
Just a killer. One left on the shot clock after a pretty good defensive possession.
Whistle as the shot goes up. 6-point edge to Stony Brook.
The play from earlier, Dan, you see, he notices the mismatch, gets the smaller guard on him. The bigs are behind Delonte. Just makes that strong move, clears a little space, and gets the layup.
Charlie Jones will stuck out. Paris Margos back on the floor for the Eagles.
Saw Jesse Reed talking to the bench. I think just trying to figure out who he was supposed to guard. Well, kind of pretty demonstrative about it.
Vosage, who we saw a lot of down the stretch last year. Versatile player in the lane. Turnaround hook shot, no good. And the rebound comes down for the Seawolves. Pass across the floor. Secunda able to save that one from going into the seats. Now the shot is up. That's no good. Loose basketball. It's tipped out of bounds, and the Eagles will get possession.
You can see Delonte bringing his rebounding shoes. He's getting up there for some rebounds. Again, these guys, looks like they may be over the break, the exam break. They've committed to doing a little more rebounding. Again, we saw that last year with that undersized lineup that Mike Brennan brought on the court. You don't have to be big to rebound. You just have to have some heart and be able to get in the right position.
Eagles entering play tonight, on average, being out-rebounded by four a game. Been only a couple contests this year where the Eagles have led in that department, so that'd be a nice thing for AU to focus in on. 5 seconds on the Eagles shot clock. Washington passes to Margos underneath. Nice up and in for the Eagles big guy, who has 4 points. The Eagles now trail by just four.
Pretty little give and go there.
Underneath, Secunda now playing with 5 points. Back up to a 6-point lead for the Seawolves.
And the Eagles just fell asleep on defense there. Saw Mike Brennan getting pretty hot at one of his players out on the court.
Underneath, reverses up and in for Jesse Reed. Off-balance shot. It almost didn't go, but he had that touch and the little luck. Able to get it to go, and now at the other end. A whistle, as I think they're going to say he stepped out.
No, I believe it was a foul on the play.
Yep, it's going to be a foul, and we're going to take a timeout. 7:46 left to play here in the first. 4-point lead for the Seawolves on the Patriot League Network.
Thanks to AU Hoops Talk with Coach Brandon Radio Show. Here's a good theme on Federal News Radio, 1800 and 1050 AM. Listen each week now through March as Coach gets you ready with previews and recaps of all home and away games and provides the inside scoop on your Eagles men's basketball team. Catch the next airing of AU Hoops Talk with Coach Brandon prior to the Maryland Eastern Shore game this Sunday at 12:30 p.m. on 1050 a.m. Visit the Bolton Media tab of AUEagles.com for complete show schedules, archive episodes, and downloadable podcasts.
Score tied once, and Stony Brook, though, has gone on a little bit of a run, and they've led for a while, a little over 6 minutes so far.
Well, I think the one thing you're kind of happy with the American is you haven't had any scoring droughts, and that's what's really hurt them in the games they've lost this year, those long droughts from the field.
Purifoy's shot is up, and it's good.
A lot of these games, they just don't score over a five-minute span, and against a quality opponent, you can't win basketball games, but you got to be getting something.
Unable to get that one to go. Eagles right now have Margos, Reed, Washington, Vosage, and Delonte Jones on the floor. playing down five. Ten seconds on the Eagles shot clock. Reed slings it out to the freshman, Washington. Now Maragos will take it back. As Washington got going, there's going to be a whistle. That's going to go against Maragos.
Yeah, another moving screen on the Eagles. Modic got called for one earlier. Now Paris gets one.
McGrew works it out to Walker. Now Puriefoy passes outside. Three-point attempt is up, and it's good from Secunda.
That's the thing. They can break you down with a dribble, and then they got shooters on the outside that can hit shots. And we've seen a few guys already knock down threes, and that's what makes this Stony Brook team really hard to defend.
They shoot 32% from beyond the arc as a team, the Seawolves do. Eagles, in case you're wondering, just below 30%. Pass underneath, and Reed takes another tumble to the floor.
And the thing I noticed by looking over the stats, Dan, is it seems like their three-point shooters know their role, and the guys who aren't three-point shooters don't. There's a few guys in here that are good players that don't shoot threes. They have their 0-for-0 on the year, so they're not jacking up a couple, I'll shoot one here. It's like, no, I'm going to be down the post. I'm going to get my points over here. Our three-point shooters are going to stay outside. They're going to be the guys scoring out that way. And sometimes that's good because you'll see teams that just don't know their guys or don't know what they should do, and they're just shooting bad shots they really can't hit.
And that comes from experience, which, as we mentioned, the Seawolves definitely have with all of their starters returning. Launching a three ball, making a three ball, Delonte Jones. Nice shot there from Delonte, able to rise up. Walker looking to answer. His shot is up, and it rattles home.
Again, Eagles got to get back and get in front of the guys with the ball. They're seeing too many shots in transition, guys wide open, and that's why I think Mike Brendan's taking the timeout. He's pretty hot right now. There's not a lot that gets Coach Brendan really, really mad, but one way to do it is to not get back on defense and give up easy buckets that way.
Do your part to support the accomplishments.
As Delonte makes that shot there, fans want to remind you tonight's game brought to you in part by Geico Insurance. Be sure to visit geico.com where 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on your car insurance. Broadcast on the Patriot League Network, powered by Campus Insiders, also brought to you by DC Trails Charter Bus Transportation Services. Glad to have you aboard. The Eagles happy to be home for the holidays. Well, I guess not really, because we have the game against UMES on Sunday. Then we hit the road for LSU. That'll be an interesting contest going up against Ben Simmons, who's looked at as a one-and-done, perhaps the top pick in the upcoming NBA draft. And then it's time for the Christmas break.
And then, of course, the game against Loyola a day before our New Year's.
Maragos' turnaround shot is no good, but there is going to be a whistle, and that's going to go on Jameel Warney. Looked at by many as the top player in the America East Conference, two-time player of the year, averaging 19 points, 12 rebounds a game. Maragos, deliberate at the charity stripe, his shot is up, and it's good.
Warney still pleading his case, and the referee kind of smiles at him but said, "No, you found him, big guy."
6'8", 260 pounds. That's what Warney checks in at. Maragos able to connect on that one as well. So he now has 6 points, and the Eagles trail by five. Andrea Modic back onto the floor in place of Maragos.
And if you're Warney, you have to love the fact that, well, you know, teams like the Warriors kind of maybe open the door for you where you can be an undersized center in the big time.
That shot is up, but there's going to be a whistle on the floor. So before the shot, that's going to go on Modic. So Modic now has 3 fouls. He's going to step out, and Maragos is back into the contest. Inbounds pass goes to Woodhouse. Nyama fires out to Walker. He goes. His shot's knocked away. However, the putback, no good. Loose basketball, and it ends up near us.
was ready. I forgot to slap my laptop down.
Yeah, usually that's your go-to move.
That's what I should do, but I was actually trying to see where the ball was going there. I think I could have caught Washington, too, if he came. He's not that big. But bigger guys, we might have to dive again.
If Warney was coming your way, that might be a bit of an issue.
Yeah, a little bit.
Warney underneath. His shot is up, and it's good. Haven't called his name in a while. Now calling it again. He's got 8 points.
Yeah, just again, good positioning by Warney. Got himself a little opening, kind of like a catcher getting the intentional walk. Got the ball out there and just made the move off of that.
Washington, turnaround shot is short. And Puriefoy comes away with it.
Warney got a piece of that. Also blocked shots.
That ends up out. That'll stay with Stony Brook.
Yeah, he's got a lot of blocked shots on the year. Let's look at his stats. I think he's averaging maybe one or two a game. So for a guy who isn't the biggest center, he's really excited. He's kind of like a regular center, just sawed off a little bit shorter. But all his game is like a seven-footer.
Purifoy's shot is up, and that's good from long range. His first made three of the game. He's a 34% shooter from beyond the arc. I think that's the first one he's taken. Maybe he's taken another one somewhere along the way, but it's now a 10-point lead for Stony Brook. Maragos has it knocked away by Warney. Now they're passing ahead, but it'll be Washington to intercept for AU. Delonte wide open from the corner, puts up the three and makes it. A triple from the Eagles freshman, who now has 12 points on the night.
Kids feeling it from the outside. Keep shooting it, get those wide open looks.
Underneath, the shot is short, but the putback is good from Warney. He's got 10 points, and that's what makes him so tough. He just fills up so much of the paint underneath.
Well, that time, I don't think that's what they wanted to see guard, the way they wanted to see him guarded. Maragos went up, just couldn't tap it away. As we get a whistle on Stony Brook, looks like Marco Vasic is going to come in for Maragos. It'll be interesting to see how they guard this way. We know Marco, as we see the three from Delonte, just gets the opening and takes it. But we saw last year, that was one thing that Marco did excel at. When he go up against bigger centers, he's so active. He'll be the guy that'll run back and forth, just keep denying the basketball. He has no problem with that motor. So I think that's what Mike Brennan's going to go for, try that against the big man for Stony Brook.
Reed trying to thread the needle there. The pass maybe had a little bit too much on it for Washington to be able to handle. It looked like he flinched for a split second. So Stony Brook will get possession here with a 9-point edge.
So we'll see this time down. Obviously got to keep a watch to see. You would think Stony Brook will go ahead and test out that smallish American lineup. And we'll see exactly how they pick it up. I'm sure they'll switch up a little bit when Warney gets down in the paint.
Warney holding the basketball now. His handoff goes to Walker. Vasic knocking it away, but knocking it into Purifoy's hands. The thought there was good from Marco. Woodhouse passing off to Nayama with 5 seconds on the shot clock off the front part of the rim. Charlie Jones going up and winning the battle against Warney.
See, and then Mike Brennan kind of saying to the bench, that's how we got to play him. You got to be active against him. Marco did it perfectly.
Vasic there trying to find Charlie, unable to do so. Now the pass ahead to Walker, who's able to finish with the layup. Walker now with 5 points. It's an 11-point lead for the Seawolves. Vasic, a sixth man most of last season till the stretch run. Plays so many different positions, so valuable during that run for the Eagles. The shot is up and no good from Charlie Jones. Earned himself a starting role down the stretch last year and a starting role in the beginning of this season, before Coach Brennan decided that the freshmen, Delonte Jones and James Washington, needed some time. Underneath, the reverse is up and in as Walker's able to finish. They're getting him involved much more here the last few possessions. He's got 7 points.
Yeah, I think that ball might actually be tipped away. It just happened to go right to the guard as he puts it up and in.
Jones tumbles down, loose basketball. Vasic picks it up. 5 seconds on the Eagles' shot clock. Vasic, now Reed launching one from long long distance and connecting. Jesse Reed stepping back. He's got 6 points, and we've seen him a few times this year try those really, really long ones, unable to make them. There he was able to make them, and Steve Peichel is going to call a timeout.
This one's going to stretch out to a full.
And so we'll take a timeout on the floor. With 1:49 left to play here in the first, it's a 10-point lead for Stony Brook on the Patriot League Network. Wow.
My luck, Anthony's going to pull the upset. I have no call.
American University Basketball via the Patriot League Network, powered by Campus Insiders, is brought to you by our Team AU corporate partners, DC Trails Charter Bus Transportation Services, and Geico Insurance, who reminds you that 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit at geico.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO. Again, that's geico.com or 1-800-947-AUTO. 10-point lead for the Seawolves, 42-32 over your Eagles, just less than 2 minutes to play here in the first. Walker passing underneath to Warney. Charlie Jones getting in the way, trying to intercept, and it'll end up out.
Man, Eagles did a pretty good job. Once they've gone small against Warney, the catches haven't been as easy.
Walker, 10 seconds on the shot clock. Drives in, loses it for a second. It ends up out of bounds, and it'll stay with Stony Brook with 5 seconds left. Lonnie Rivera has entered the lineup for the Eagles. Another one of AU's freshmen, the 6'6 forward. Wearing number 15. And that is going to go against Stony Brook. The offensive foul. That goes on Lucas Woodhouse.
Kind of an interesting situation there. Usually you'll see a big screening for a guard. That time those two guards kind of working a play there, and Woodhouse just gets called for the moving screen. Again, he's a guy that really they're hoping for some good things out of the transfer for Longwood, but I think out of the last, earlier in the season, missed a nice stretch of games with that knee injury. It was kind of going on and off being able to play, so probably still not 100%.
Vosage passes off to Delonte. Loses his footing. We've seen that a couple times tonight. I don't know if his sneakers have an issue or maybe the floor's been buffed a little bit too much, but we've seen him almost lose his footing a couple times. 4 seconds. Delonte's shot is up, and it's no good. And the rebound pulled down for Walker. Now underneath, the shot is up, and it's good. Able to finish there is Warney.
Yeah, Warney kind of shaking off his hand. I think he got caught. Charlie Jones went for the block and could have got called for a foul there. Referees let it go, but Warney definitely took some contact.
Puriefoy knocks it away, takes it the other way, and lays it up and in. Transition point, steal, and a bucket for Puriefoy.
It's not a good pass. You know, Puriefoy, an experienced guard. You can't throw one out there in front of him like that. He'll get it every time.
4 seconds separate game clock from shot clock. Underneath, the shot is up and good for Jesse Reed. The assist to Marco Vosage.
Yeah, and Eagles with some good cuts tonight. Offense has not been the problem. 34 points against a quality Stony Brook team. You got to be happy with that if you're Mike Brennan, just giving up too many. And some of that be kind of turnovers, other issues.
The shot's up. That rattles around. No good. Jesse Reed has the basketball, and he'll just hold it. And that'll bring us to halftime, where it's a 46-34 lead for Stony Brook.
And again, Eagles down here at the half, but again, we at least we've seen some things out of their offense. They can tighten the defense up. They'll have a shot here in the second half to make the comeback against the quality Stony Brook team.
12 points, that's what the Seawolves lead the Eagles by. It's halftime here at Bender Arena. We'll take a timeout. Halftime show comes your way next on the Patriot League Network.